brothers and sisters. I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me?
Hard this last 3 weeks. You've grown as a person and learned much away about the ways of a ninja. I am proud of all you have accomplished.
Really? Thanks, Sensei.
But Eugene-san, you still have much to learn.
I do.
A true ninja always has much to learn. There's much more I can teach about being quick, being strong, being stealthy.
Is that so?
There are things you can learn about diet and exercise.
You don't say, Sensei.
And there are other things to learn. Ninja things, like nunchucks, sword skills, throwing star skills.
So you've been holding back on all the good stuff.
But if you're going to learn these things, you must learn above all else. You must learn to listen to your master. You cannot rely on your own wisdom, you must rely on mine.
Well, okay then.
Okay?
Yeah. Okay then.
Really? Just like that?
Yeah. If you want me to rely on you, I will. Why are you so surprised, Sensei? You want me to be a good student,
of
right?
Of course.
Then why wouldn't I listen to you?
Look, Eugene-san, you wouldn't listen to me before. You thought you could do it all on your own.
Yeah, but a person can't grow up, can't they?
Eugene-san, you're not merely just grown up. You've grown wise.
I am?
I'm truly proud of you. With an attitude like that, you can become a great student and an awesome ninja.
You mean that, Sensei?
I mean it.
Huh. Even better than Snake Eyes from G.I. Joe?
Better than him.
Then, Sensei, teach me. Whatever you have to say, I'm all ears.
Hey guys, back again in our final series of Ninja Bible. So, Bible Ninjas, there we go. Today we're gonna play Ninja Says. I am going to be the ninja telling you guys what to do. It's kind of like Simon Says. So you can only move or do the move if I say Ninja Says. If I don't say Ninja Says, then you're out.
Okay.
First person to not follow that loses.
Wait, to not
to not follow the direction of Ninja says.
Yeah, it's like Simon says.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. Make the best one win.
All right, you guys ready? Get in. Ninja says, get in your ninja pose. Ninja says, do two jumping jacks. Ninja says, spin around in a circle once. Ninja says, jump up and down. Ninja didn't say stop. Ninja says, clap your hands. Ninja says, clap your hands behind your back. Keep going. Stop. Ninja says, stop. Ninja says, touch your toes. Ninja says, touch your head. Ninja says, touch your knees. Ninja says, touch your shoulders. Touch your toes. Ninja says, flip your hair.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Ninja says, crisscross your legs.
You have to go back.
Ninja says, touch your elbows. Ninja says, freeze. Ninja says, make your best ninja sound.
Whoa.
Ninja says, make your best ninja pose and sound.
Whoa.
Ninja says, jump up and down till you can't stop. Ninja says, touch your nose. Ninja says, jump on one leg. Stop.
You didn't say stop.
Dang, okay. Ninja says, touch your ear. I didn't say stop touching your nose. Ninja says, stop jumping. Ninja says, stand two arms by your side. Ninja says, look up, look down.
I hope you didn't say that.
Yeah.
All right, I think both of you guys got that one. So it's a tie, it's a draw. Rock, paper, scissors, best one out of one. Ready? Back to back. One, two, three. Turn back around. All right, get your weapon or your rock, paper, or scissors. Get it ready. All right, you have it ready. Spin around on the count of three. One. Let me see yours.
Two, three.
No, but you need both. You both need to change. Back to back. Ready? Get your weapon ready. Ready? Set. Go.
Paper. She did this though.
She was uncovering it. She did the last one too. She did the last one too. Ivory is the winner. Ivory is the winner. Good game. GG. Shake on it. And let's jam in our lesson. Bye guys. All right, Ivory and Micah. We are ready to jam into our final lesson of Bible Ninjas. Are you guys ready for this?
Yes.
Good. So we've talked about how wisdoms have to be stealthy, how they have to be super quick, and how they have to be strong. So today we're going to talk about one of the most important things, and we're going to focus on wisdom. What is something that you guys can think of that every ninja or good warrior has?
A weapon, a sword.
Okay, a weapon.
Has good, wise, they're all wise.
Okay.
And they know how to be light on their feet.
Good, so wisdom and good maybe skills. Mm-hmm. Ivory, what are you thinking?
A good sensei or trainer or someone that's very, very wise.
I already read in my mind.
Done this before. And always has weapons, like Micah said. And the army warriors, they have guns and stuff and bombs and stuff like that. But ninjas have nunchucks and stars and stuff like that.
Like their own type of weapon.
Very good. So the answer I was looking for, Ivory actually got it right on the nose. You guys were both right. Those are all different things that ninjas have. All ninjas also have a very good teacher. Teachers are essential for ninjas, you guys as students, or just us as people, right? So what the senseis or masters or their teachers do, they always teach the ninjas wisdom, right? Maybe on what decisions to make, what moves to make, what missions maybe to accept, right? Mm-hmm. People who want to become ninjas aren't always born that way. They're not just born a ninja in a ninja costume and they know everything what to do, right? Mm-hmm. Did you guys always know everything what to do?
No.
Always, all the time? Mm-hmm. When you just popped out and you're just ready, you're 1 year old, you knew how to hold a spoon and everything?
A walk.
Yeah, and even then, if you see some one-year-olds, they kind of fall when they walk too, right?
Yeah.
A little bit. So ninjas rely on their masters to teach them all these fundamentals. So people who want to become ninjas, they're not always born that way, right? So when you guys came out, were you guys born knowing how to hold a spoon?
No.
Or talk, right?
Yeah.
None of that. Someone had to teach you that thing, right? Whether it was your parents or siblings, someone had to teach you. So ninjas, they rely on their masters or their senseis to teach them these fundamentals. So if a student is unwilling to listen to their master, what do you guys think would happen?
They could get beat up and...
Or they might not even become a ninja.
Yeah, they just not quiet and just go stomp, 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 stomp. Not wearing the right shoes.
So making all kinds of mistakes is what I'm hearing.
Like you, if you won't learn from someone, like usually when you have a sensei, they probably learn from their own mistakes, and then like they'll tell you what not to do.
Mm-hmm.
So then like after that, like you'll learn like, oh, I'll do this. So if you don't have someone to teach you, like you'll never learn.
This is true, right? You'll never learn. And even then, do you think that a master or a teacher would want to teach someone who doesn't want to learn?
No.
Probably not at all, right? So someone has to teach you this wisdom. So I want to give you guys a scenario. Imagine you just got done maybe playing with your friends at recess, maybe finishing basketball practice or softball practice, anything along those lines. We have three snacks on the table. We have Funyuns, veggies, and Reese's. What do you think is the best snack to eat after practice?
Something really healthy. Yeah, like veggies.
The veggies? Why not the chips?
That's because they won't...
Junk food.
Yeah, they won't, like, and help you build up and, like, these run easily.
These two things, okay. See, you... They're different from these. This okay. is a healthy, this mm-hmm. is junk food. And usually when you work out, it makes you healthy. So why would you want to, like, I feel like after you eat like junk food, like what was the purpose of even doing a workout if you're going to eat junk food after?
This is very good. That's a yeah. good point. And so I think what you guys do, you know that the vegetables or the veggies, that's going to give you fuel and nourishment, right? Mm-hmm. You know that. But your wisdom that comes out in your actions is actually choosing the veggies. Right? Mm-hmm. That's the difference between knowledge and wisdom. Wisdom is your actual actions. So every good student is actually willing to listen to their teachers. It sounds like, Micah, you were ready to listen to maybe something a coach told you or maybe your mom or your siblings, because I know they play sports, right? Mm-hmm. So if you want to learn math, who do you have to listen to probably?
Your
math
teacher.
Yeah.
Right. If you want to learn basketball, who would you probably listen
your
to?
Your coach.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And if you want to be wise, who might be some people you could listen to?
My God. Dad. And God mm-hmm. and Jesus and the Holy Ghost and people like that.
Yeah, I think all those are good answers.
People that know that is wise.
Yeah, yeah, really good. I want you guys, so we're going to do the next thing. I want you guys to pull your plate kind of close to you because you were going to wet some sponges now.
Yay.
Let's go ahead and yeah. show everyone your sponge at home. So our sponges are going to represent Ivory and Micah. This is them in sponge form. So next up, what I want you guys to do is grab your spray bottle. So your spray bottle is going to represent essentially maybe the answers you guys are going to give me. So maybe things that people have poured into you and taught you. So what I want you guys to do is you're going to hold your sponge. Can I see your spray bottle, Ivory?
Yes.
You're going to hold it and maybe spray it 1, 2, 3 with each answer you give me. So my first question is for one of you to tell me what is one of the 10 commandments.
Oh.
What is one of them? Ivory?
Don't lie, don't cheat, don't steal. Mm-hmm. Always obey your parents.
You gave me 2 of them. Oh, 3. Yeah, you gave me 3 of them. Good job.
Don't murder.
Yeah,
that's
definitely.
That's a very good one.
Very good one. All right, you guys, in your sponges, go ahead and spray it 3 times. Ooh, that's okay. If you hold it, it might be better.
Okay.
There we go.
3. All right, what is something else that is, okay, what is it to have good manners? What's an example of having good manners? Micah?
Example of having good manners is not to be disrespectful and be humble.
What's an example of that?
Maybe like an actual like.
Mm-hmm. So if I say, just give me this. Is that good manners?
No, what you have to do, you ask politely.
How do you do that? Give me that.
Hi, could I please have that because I want to use it, and then after I'm done, I'll give it back.
Give me some. It's a little bit extra. Go ahead and spray that sponge 3 times. All right. Now, what is something, if someone calls me a name, a really bad name, someone called me a big, fat, stupid head, what would be me practicing wisdom? Ivory?
Saying, like, that's not really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Like, probably, like, it's not really nice. You could probably not do that to anyone. I could give you some advice and not do that.
Okay, Micah.
Or maybe you can say, what if I said that to you? How would that make you feel?
Good.
And I would say, you know, I feel bad. Because mm-hmm. sometimes when people are mean to you, people might be mean to them. So they might put like their anger on other people. So you could say, hey, if you apologize mm-hmm. to me and yourself for what you have done, we can still, maybe we can be friends and let that be passed on.
Okay.
That's really good.
Good. I think that was good. Let's spray 10 times.
10?
10 times. Let's get all the water in there,
1,
too.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right. Done. What is a piece of wisdom that you might have gained either from your parents, from church, from school? What is something that maybe some advice or something that someone has taught you that you think has given you wisdom?
To not be a follower, be a leader.
I like that. What are you thinking?
Something that my mom told me at fortune school is what Micah said.
Mm-hmm. I could have fortune.
Fortune school is not that good, but
mm-mm.
Sorry. But anyway.
You want to stick with being a, let's not be a follower, be a leader?
Yeah.
And that's another, do another 10. Let's do another 10.
Okay.
Big ones in there.
Okay, I'll do this.
But you have a plate right here, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
And then what I want you guys to do, this, so your sponge is all the wisdom that people, things that, that people have told you, right? And I want you to hold your sponges up over the plate and squeeze them and see if any water comes out. So Micah looks like she has a lot. Ivory has some coming out. So these things that people are telling you guys, when you bring out your actions and share this wisdom with other people, the water coming out is your actions flowing and pouring into other people too. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Right. Awesome. Give me some. I know your hands are wet, but give me some. Yeah, Micah, it's like, kind of like the follower aspect. You're being a leader and sharing this wisdom with other people. Awesome. So you can go ahead and set the sponges down. So initially, if we listen to wisdom that our leaders want to share with us, then we can apply that wisdom to our lives, just like you guys showed me in the sponge. So Micah, can you do us a favor and go ahead and read Proverbs chapter 4, verses 10 through 15?
I would like to. Listen, my son, accept what I say, and the years of your life will be many. I instruct you in the way of wisdom and lead you along straight paths. When you walk in your steps, you will not be hampered.
Mm-hmm.
Do not set a foot. Wait, no. When you run, you will not stumble. Hold on to instruction. Do not let it go. Guard it well, for it is your life. Do not set foot on the path of the wicked, or walk in the ways of evildoers. Avoid and avoid it. Do not travel on it, onto it. Turn from it and go on your own path.
Awesome. Good job, Micah. Give me some. So King Solomon, throughout all of Proverbs, he gives all these really good speeches to people, right? He's like, hey, listen up. Listen to what I have to say, because there's some wisdom in this. And so Solomon didn't write the book for himself, because he already had all this amazing wisdom. He wrote it to his children and people like us today so that we can be wise just like he was. So God has given us teachers, mentors, pastors, coaches, and even parents to teach us about life and teach us some things about wisdom, just like you guys gave examples of earlier. He's given us adults who can share their life experiences. Like Micah was saying, a teacher has probably been through something to teach the student, right? And so ultimately, adults have a lot to teach us, right? Whether it's kids and it's about maybe life and it's about faith and even wisdom. Adults have a lot to teach us, right? So God wants all of us, even grown-ups, to find and follow wise teachers. So even I have teachers. I have people I learn from, right? And so he wants us to listen so that we can grow in our faith and become, what's that W word?
Wise.
Yep, and that's kind of a trick question, because we've been saying wisdom all day.
Yeah.
So we can grow wise. Really good. So some of the different, like, teachers we have in our lives, I listed them earlier, right? So I want you guys throughout this week, and you guys at home as well, I want you guys to think about the people you learn from, right? Whether it's your parents, it's siblings, maybe it's your teachers. Think about what they teach you and how they teach you, maybe about science and math or English, maybe about good sportsmanship if you're playing sports, right? Maybe
or even a stranger.
Yeah.
Like you might see them in public.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's a good one. Yeah, at school too. I know some of us are going back.
It doesn't have to be
someone you know. Mm-hmm. That's a really good point, Micah, because sometimes we can see maybe people on the street being really nice to somebody, mm-hmm. and we can learn a little bit about kindness in that situation, right? So when you're listening to the advice of elders, you gain wisdom. So how many of, okay, can you two think of, I don't want the story just yet, but can you two think of a time when someone taught you wisdom? Whether it's a teacher, a coach, or a parent, when someone taught you maybe, and they weren't saying, hey, this is wisdom, listen, but maybe they taught you something and you learned later on why.
Yeah.
Okay, I have like two.
So a few, we can have a different stories, right?
Yeah.
Hold on to those different kinds of stories, because as you get older, you can share those with other people as well to also teach them wisdom.
Pass on.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So now you can go and maybe try to make all the same mistakes that your other teachers and mentors, coaches have tried to teach you not to do. But why learn the hard way? If they tell you not to do it, they taught you what's happened, you have it a little bit easier and you can help someone else too, right? Mm-hmm. You can save yourself a lot of trouble by listening to those who are very, very wise. Mm-hmm. So every ninja has a master or a sensei, and every believer, every Christian believer needs a mentor, whether it's a pastor or it's a teacher, someone who helps lead them and disciple them. And adults also need mentors. Mm-hmm. So as we go through life, what is that W word that we really need?
Why?
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
Both of them. It's the same thing.
Yeah.
Give me some. Wisdom, right? And we can get a lot of that from reading our Bible, especially in Proverbs from King Solomon. So ultimately, our goal is to learn to be wise, think about people who have taught us different things throughout the week, mm-hmm. right? Whether it's teachers, coaches, pastors, all those things, and think about how we can maybe even thank them for teaching us these things. Sound good?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Ivory. Yeah, give back. Would you like to close us in prayer, or do you want me to?
Sure.
Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and thank God for the teachers and parents that have helped teach us.
Okay.
Okay.
Dear Lord, thank you for this time, and I really pray that the people watching at home, that they learn some wisdom today, and that maybe if there's parents watching, they could too, and everyone could. And I pray for those that, like, taught people that actually did stuff, like sensei or something like that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.